So this clip was a huge success when I posted it a couple of months ago on Facebook, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how I made the doors of that locomotive stall open smoothly and close smoothly, all controlled via a decoder. So I started by taking this Faller locomotive stall kit, so a modern one, and then first I assemble it according to the manual. So just see how I did it. Here I'm using my usual technique to make LED lighting inside the building. I solder very thin copper wire on SMD LEDs and then I glue them on the frame of the building. The foundation of the building is held by some helper plastics which need to be removed at a later point, but they are quite stiff, so it's better to make a little cut there, so it's really easier to remove them when it's finally time to do it. So here I mount the original mechanism to open and close the door in the building. So be careful not to glue it, otherwise it will not work. So that's done. I don't glue the roof to have easier access, and this plastic to hold, that's to hold the original motor from Faller, which we not going to use in this case. So, and then I modeled this holding bracket to hold a servo and put it where this holding plus bit will be. I have this file available, and also this is the adapter piece to connect it to the mechanism. So if you want to 3D print it, check the link in the description. So, and then I put the holding bracket inside the locomotive stall here. It fits exactly in these four little holes. And then I mount the servo. It's a small servo I bought, which will fit in that exactly. And then I screw it in place. Then I cut and bend a piece of servo wire to connect the servo motor with the actual door open mechanism. Then I connect the servo to my Arduino test rig and I check that everything works as expected. Then we need actually to make the cable of the servo longer, so I need to solder some very thin wire so I can hide them in the pillar of the building. Then I used bonded UV glue to glue the adapter piece to the servo mechanism, and then I pulled the thin wires through that hole, which is possible, which is normally used also for the cable of the motor. Then I solder the servo connector to the other end of the cables. Then I check as usual everything as it's still working. And then I use bonded UV glue to isolate the wires so they don't short circuit. Now we are at the train room and I made some holes to pull all the wires. Then it's just a bit of patience to pull all the wires through the all the holes, and also for the lights. Yeah, because I have the thin wires going directly under, you have to be careful not to destroyed what actually happened to one of them, so I had to solder an emergency piece of wire. So, and then I have a ASU switch pilot servo under this plate, and then it was just to connect and just to program the servo that the door open and close properly. In case your values are out of range of the servo, it might pull the cable into a of the servo mechanism in a bad position, so you will have to open it and put it back manually. But if you do it with patience, step by step, that should not happen. So that was the tutorial of the installation of servo in the Faller electrolocomotive stall. I hope it was interesting for you, and if you want to recreate it, the files are in the description, so you can download them and use them. They should be scaled properly, otherwise you have to do some test run. So If you haven't done it, then subscribe to this channel and also subscribe to our Facebook page where you will see a lot of bonus content. See you soon again in the train room.